Hello and welcome to Parliament This Week, our weekly roundup of the events that took place in both Houses of Parliament. I'm Teena Jha. Contrary to all apprehensions, in the backdrop of continuous disruptions of both houses, especially in the second half of the budget session, the monsoon session that started this week had a smooth start, with both houses functioning normally. The highlight of the week was, of course, the marathon debate in the Lok Sabha on the no-confidence motion against the Modi government that was comprehensively beaten in the lower house. We'll get you details on that story, but first, the headlines. BJP-led government defeats opposition's no-confidence motion in the Lok Sabha. After a marathon debate spanning 12 hours, 126 members vote for the measure, 325 members against it. Prime Minister Modi defends his government's record in his tenure. Parliament passes five bills, three in the upper house, two in the Lok Sabha. In all, 10 bills introduced in the first week of the monsoon session. The Armed Forces Tribunal Amendment Bill 2012 withdrawn in Rajya Sabha. Centre takes steps on incidents of mob lynching. Home Minister Rajnath Singh informs Lok Sabha that states told to take stringent action against the culprits. Social media service providers asked to install checks to stop spread of rumours and fake news. And Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu speaks in 10 languages to tell members they can now speak in their mother tongue in Rajya Sabha. New interpretation facility allows the upper house to have simultaneous translation in 22 languages. Well, the Narendra Modi government comfortably defeated the no-confidence motion in the Lok Sabha on Friday. The motion got 325 votes in favour of the government and 126 against, which indicated that the BJP had secured the support of more than just its allies.
Expresses its want of confidence in the Council of Ministers. Those in favour may say aye. Those against may say no. Now the division.
After a raging 12-hour debate in the Lok Sabha, the NDA government on Friday comfortably defeated the no-confidence motion moved against it by the opposition in the lower house. It was 27th no-confidence motion taken up in the history of Indian Parliament. The Modi-led NDA sailed through the vote, bagging more votes than its floor leaders had predicted. The motion was defeated with 325 votes in favour of the government and 126 against. The Shiv Sena with its 18 members and the BJD with 19 skipped the debate, bringing down the strength of the house.
Subject to correction, the result of the division is ayes 126, noes 325. So noes have it, noes have it, motion is negative.
The evening belonged to Modi as he delivered a 100-minute speech that had just about enough to keep his party's core supporters enthusiastic. Replying to the debate that saw Congress President Rahul Gandhi mount a fierce attack on the centre, Prime Minister Modi accused the Congress of conspiring to incite instability in the country by supporting a pointless no-confidence motion.
मैं नहीं मानता हूँ कि कोई अज्ञानवश हुआ है और न ही ये झूठे आत्मविश्वास के कारण हुआ है. ये इसलिए हुआ है कि अहंकार इस प्रकार की प्रवृत्ति करने के लिए खींच के ले जा रहा है. ये सरकार का फ्लोर टेस्ट नहीं है. ये तो कांग्रेस का अपने तथाकथित साथियों का फ्लोर टेस्ट है. मैं ही प्रधान बनूंगा, प्रधानमंत्री बनूंगा के सपने पर और दर भी थोड़े मोहर लगा दें, इसके लिए ट्रायल चल रहा है.
इन अ स्पीच He also advised his opponents to try their luck with another no-confidence motion in 2024.
मैं फिर एक बार इन सभी महानुभावों को 2024 में अविश्वास प्रस्ताव लाने का निमंत्रण देकर के मेरी बात को समाप्त करता हूँ.
The Prime Minister assured the people of Andhra Pradesh that they will not be left behind and the government will ensure their welfare and development.
मैं आंध्र की जनता को विश्वास दिलाना चाहता हूं, चाहे राजधानी का काम हो, चाहे किसानों की भलाई का काम हो, केंद्र सरकार, एनडीए की सरकार, आंध्र की जनता के कल्याण के काम में कोई पीछे नहीं रहेगी, उनके जो मदद कर सकते हैं, हम करते रहेंगे, आंध्र का भला हो, उसी में देश का भला हो, ये हमारी सोच है।
The debate also saw the opposition trade charges, with Congress President Rahul Gandhi taking on the government on a variety of issues.
Pradhan Mantri, aapne 2.5 lakh crore rupaye Hindustan ke sabse ameer 20-25 udyogpatiyon ka maaf kiya. Karza maaf kiya. Pradhan Mantri ji, Hindustan ka kisan kehta hai maaf, aapne unka kiya. हाथ जोड़ के आपसे कहता है हमारा भी थोड़ा सा माफ कर दीजिए और फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर कहते हैं नहीं 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 नहीं
The Congress president also attacked Defence Minister Nirmala Sitharaman and the Prime Minister on the Rafael fighter jet deal.
Rafael हवाई जहाज सिंधिया जी जरा दिखाइए हमारी यूपीए की डील में हवाई जहाज का दाम 520 करोड़ रुपए प्रति हवाई जहाज जादू से हवाई जहाज का दाम 1600 करोड़ रुपए प्रति हवाई जहाज हो गया उसके बाद डिफेंस मिनिस्टर ने क्लियरली बोला कि मैं ये आंकड़ा नहीं दे सकती हूं क्योंकि फ्रांस की सरकार और हिंदुस्तान की सरकार के बीच में एक सीक्रेसी पैक्ट है
The heated debate was initiated by TDP's Jaydev Gala, who criticized the Modi government for ignoring the interests of Andhra Pradesh.
This no confidence motion has been brought by the TDP for four reasons: fairness, trust, priority, and bias. Or rather, lack of fairness, lack of trust, lack of priority, and lack of an unbiased approach towards Andhra Pradesh. Nothing has been done so far on the special package. We are demanding to implement the cabinet decision on special category status to Andhra Pradesh, madam.
Biggest economic gamble is sarkar ne ki note bandi ke mamle mein. Aur usme hamare haath mein kuch nahi mila.
Andhra Pradesh ke logon ke hit mein hum ye kadam uthaye hain. और उनको संख्या बल नहीं रहते हुए भी हम सभी 48 मेंबर्स टीएमसी के मेंबर्स और सीपीएम सीपीआई और आरएसपी सभी मेंबर मुस्लिम लीग सभी मिलके उनको सपोर्ट किए
यूपीए गवर्नमेंट रूल ऑफ 10 इयर्स एंड 4 इयर्स ऑफ एनडीए हैज डन इनजस्टिस टू द पीपल ऑफ उड़ीसा दिस डिस्कशन विल नॉट बी एनी वे फ्रूटफुल फॉर द पीपल ऑफ उड़ीसा देयरफॉर वी आर working out we are not participating in this discussion
sponsor scheme for the welfare of the scheduled caste and scheduled tribes and due to committed liability the finance of the state government had been put to a lot of stress the state is yet to receive an amount of rupees 1803.4 crores arrears of the up to 2017-18 from the government of india I request the center to immediately release this centrally assistant to Tamil Nadu.
Suspicion, doubt है. गठबंधन को लेकर भी संशय बना हुआ है. एक यदि गठबंधन हो गया तो आगे चलेगा कि नहीं चलेगा. इसको भी लेकर जो है संशय बना हुआ है. इसका नेता कौन होगा?
People's expectation of this government across the nation are not fulfilled. And their expectations are not fulfilled by Modi ji's government.
Our chief minister says already there is no confidence against the government. Wherever there is a by-election held, the BJP loses. They have lost in Uluwadiya by 5 lakh votes, West Bengal, Gorakhpur, Phulpur, and Kairana in UP. They have lost Araria. In Bihar, they have lost. Bhandara, Gondia, in Maharashtra, they have lost.
The no confidence motion was moved by Telugu Desam parties, K. Srinivas in the Lok Sabha. The last time a no confidence motion was voted on in Parliament was in 2003, when BJP icon Atal Bihari Vajpayee's NDA government easily defeated a no confidence motion brought by the Congress's Sonia Gandhi. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And let's now take a look at the five bills which were passed in the Parliament this week.
I can come. On the first day of the monsoon session of Parliament, the Upper House passed two bills. The Requisitioning and Acquisition of Immovable Property Amendment Bill 2017 was passed by a voice vote. The bill amends Requisitioning and Acquisition of Immovable Property Act 1952, thereby allowing the centre to reissue the notice of acquisition to ensure that the property owner gets an opportunity to be heard. The property owner will also be entitled to interest on the compensation payable to him or her in cases where a notice has been reissued. Enhanced compensation will be awarded only when the notice of acquisition has been reissued by the government and the property is being acquired by it for national security and defence purposes.
जो बिल्स आपके सामने रखा है उसका एक बहुत लिमिटेड पर्पस है वो है कि फेयर कॉम्पनसेशन दी जाए और फेयर कॉम्पनसेशन वो होगी जो ओरिजिनल डेट ऑफ नोटिफिकेशन से फिक्स डिपॉजिट इंटरेस्ट के साथ होगी अगर उसमें कोई एनामली आती है और किसी और चीज तो वी आर ऑलवेज रेडी इन अ स्पिरिट ऑफ रीजनेबल कंस्ट्रक्टिव टू डील विद इट.
The Rajya Sabha also passed the State Banks Repeal and Amendment Bill 2017 that provides for merging six subsidiary banks with the State Bank of India. The bill repeals the State Bank of India Subsidiary Banks Act 1959 and State Bank of Hyderabad Act 1956, besides amending the State Bank of India SBI Act 1955. The bill aims at rationalization of resources, reduction of costs and better profitability emerging from the merger of the subsidiary banks. The merger would lead to better rate of interest for public at large, improved productivity and customer service.
इस नाते भी किया गया कि संसाधनों के युक्तिकरण, लागतों में कमी लाने, लाभप्रदता को बढ़ाने, निधियों की कम लागत जिससे लोगों को बड़े पैमाने पर बेहतर ब्याज दर प्राप्त हो, यह देश की जनता के हित के लिए है, बैंकों के हित के लिए है, प्रबंधन के लिए है, बैंकों के द्वारा जनता को पूरी की पूरी तौर पर सुविधा मिले, इसके लिए है.
Lok Sabha passed an amendment to the right of children to free and compulsory education, Second Amendment Bill 2017. The amendment prohibits schools from detaining students till they complete their elementary education. According to the amendment bill, a child who fails in the examination held after classes 5 and 8 will be given additional instruction and the opportunity to appear for a re-examination to be held within a period of 2 months from the date of the declaration of the result. If the child still does not pass the exam, the state government may decide to detain them. The proposed amendment was introduced in August 2017 and referred to a standing committee of the Rajya Sabha. The committee presented its report to both houses of parliament in February, endorsing the amendment bill in its present form.
कि एक ऐतिहासिक निर्णय आज हमने किया है क्योंकि इस निर्णय से परीक्षा और जवाबदेही आएगी शिक्षा होगी सीखना भी होगा सिखाना भी होगा पढ़ना भी होगा और ये सब मिलकर शिक्षा समृद्ध होगी क्योंकि हमारा लक्ष्य है सबको शिक्षा अच्छी शिक्षा बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद.
The Rajya Sabha passed the Prevention of Corruption Amendment Bill 2013 on Thursday. Passed by a voice vote, the bill makes giving bribes to a public servant an offence. The bill amends the Prevention of Corruption Act 1988 to modify definitions and penalties for offences related to taking a bribe, being a habitual offender and abetting an offence. For the bribe takers, the bill proposes to increase the punishment to a minimum of 3 years of imprisonment, which may extend to 7 years besides fine. The bribe givers shall be punished up to 7 years of imprisonment or with fine or both according to the bill. However, to protect persons who give bribe under coercion, the bill has provided that persons who compelled would have to report the matter to the law enforcement authority or investigative agency within 7 days.
I agree with you in the amendments it has said pecuniary and other gratifications. Now, pecuniary of course related to money. Other means that if it is not in the form of money, if it is by other means also it should come in the purview. We could not have defined it because then you cannot keep on counting all the items which would come in that. But that is left to the wisdom of the investigating authorities and the select committee comprised of members from all the political parties.
The Lok Sabha passed the Fugitive Economic Offenders Bill 2018 by a voice vote. The bill allows for a person to be declared as a fugitive economic offender if an arrest warrant has been issued against him for any specified offences where the value involved is over 100 crore rupees, and he has left the country and refuses to return to face prosecution. The bill allows authorities to provisionally attach properties of an accused while the application is pending before the special court.
ये ऑर्डिनेंस लाना इसलिए जरूरी था कि ये कार्रवाई रुके ना, ये कार्रवाई थमे ना, और ये मैसेज जाए कि भारत सरकार अब एकदम सीरियसली नई सरकार आई है, काले धन के ऊपर प्रहार हो रहा है, और एक सीरीज ऑफ मेजर्स में ये एक मेजर लिया गया कि ऐसे जो भी केसेस हैं जहां ऑफेंडर्स भारत की सीमाओं को छोड़ के चले जाते हैं, इनको इनकी संपत्ति को जब्त करने का कानून लाया जाए, इसलिए इसको ऑर्डिनेंस के रूप में हमने पास किया। तो अगर कोई आज भगोड़ा है और बाहर रहता है तो इज ऑलरेडी अ फ्यूजिटिव, ही इज रनिंग अवे फ्रॉम इंडियन लॉ, और वो भी सेक्शन 3 के द्वारा इस कानून में कवर हो जाते हैं।
A total of 10 bills were introduced in the first week of the monsoon session, and one bill, Armed Forces Tribunal Amendment Bill 2012, was withdrawn. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu spoke in no less than 10 languages in the House on the first day of the monsoon session. He informed the upper house about the start of a service that has always been close to his heart. Members will now have simultaneous interpretation in all 22 languages to allow them to express themselves in their mother tongue inside the house. This after the Rajya Sabha Secretariat made available interpretation facility for 5 more languages.
Setting a record of sorts, Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu on Wednesday spoke in 10 languages in the upper house.
I say, हम लोग एपीनी बंगलाई भाषण ने दी थे परेवन, गुजराती में बोली सके चे, कनाडा दली मार्नाड़ द बहुतो, मलयालत्तील संस्कारिकुम, मराठी ता बोल सकता, नेवरी माँ बोलना सक्षा, ओडिरिया कोत्ता कताय हो ये परे, पंजाबी विच बोला सकता है, తమిళ్ పేసలాం తెలుగులో కూడా మాట్లాడవచ్చు తెలుగులో కూడా అందరూ మాట్లాడవచ్చు
He informed members that simultaneous interpretation service has now been made available for them to speak in any of the 22 languages listed in the 8th schedule of the constitution
I am happy to inform you that the Rajya Sabha secretariat has now made arrangements for simultaneous interpretation of the proceedings of the house in the remaining 5 languages also Dogri Kashmiri Konkani, Santhali, Sindhi, with this, the members can speak in all the 22 languages listed in the 8th schedule. I encourage honorable members to use this facility and speak in their own languages.
At the behest of the chairman, who is an ardent advocate of speaking in mother tongue, the Rajya Sabha Secretariat made available interpretation facility for 5 more languages in Dogri, Kashmiri, Konkani, Sindhi and Santhali. The upper house earlier had simultaneous interpretation services for 17 languages. Chairman Naidu also mentioned that the Rajya Sabha, for the first time in 66 years, signed a pact with the parliamentary institution of a foreign nation when it entered into an MOU with the Senate of Rwanda earlier this month. The MOU provides for the inter-parliamentary dialogue and parliamentary exchange visits.
A memorandum of understanding was signed for promoting cooperation between the upper houses of the two countries. For the first time in the last 66 years, it is coming into being, Rajya Sabha entering into a MOU with a foreign counterpart. So far, you know the practice of the parliamentary groups. Both Lok Sabha used to take initiative and there used to be a joint committee. For the first time, the upper house of that country and the upper house of India, we have entered into a MOU and we'll be having parliamentary exchanges, visits, and also meetings to understand each other's system better.
Till now, only the Lok Sabha entered into such agreements with foreign parliamentary institutions. Kriti Mishra's report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu on Thursday suggested a national policy to stop the misuse of social media to spread violence. He urged the government to hold talks with all stakeholders to arrive at implementable solutions. His assertion came after members raised the issue of misuse of social media.
Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu on Thursday voiced concerns over the misuse of social media. He urged the government to come up with the implementable solution after holding wide consultations.
This issue of misuse of the social media is a larger issue and also a sensitive and serious issue. We can't come to conclusions on one side, and you can't take unilateral action also. The moment government does something, then there will be criticism and also opposition. And then at the same time, can you allow this situation to go on? What is happening? So keeping this in mind, I can only suggest to the government to hold discussions with all the stakeholders, including political parties, and then try to evolve a national policy, because this will have international ramifications also.
The chairman's suggestion came after members expressed concern over fake news spread by social media platforms.
कभी गौ हत्या, कभी बच्चा चोरी, कभी उन्माद की अफवाह, फिर भीड़ तंत्र का अराजक होना, इसका समाधान क्या है? दो ही रास्ते हैं, कानून और तकनीक. आज तकनीक की दृष्टि से इसको किस रूप में नियंत्रित किया जा सकता है और आत्मनियंत्रण में लाया जा सकता है, ये कोशिश होनी चाहिए.
Members also voiced concern over the incidents of mob lynching and violence.
So I would urge upon the government that since the matter is posted on 20th of August, before that or at the earliest convenience, the government should come up with a comprehensive legislation before both the houses of parliament.
What is happening in the current period in our history, in the name of cow terror attacks, in the name of love jihad attacks, in the name of interfaith marriages, kind of fighting against them, violence has been unleashed.
Union Law Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad assured the House that government is taking steps to check the propagation of fake news through social media platforms.
Sir, I have already issued notice to him. If you are equally responsible for your technological platform, if it is being used in large number for abuse. They have reverted to me. They are also educating, sir. We are taking, but this session I take on board, sir.
Right.
I will hold a consultation.
Thank you.
The government also agreed to hold discussion with all the stakeholders on the issue. Kriti Mishra's report for Rajya Sabha TV. Thank you,
sir. And the centre condemned incidents of mob lynching in the Lok Sabha on Thursday. Home Minister Rajnath Singh said the states have been asked to take steps to curb such incidents. He also said social media sites have been asked to install checks to stop the spread of fake news.
The recent spate of mob lynching incidents was raised in the Lok Sabha in the 0 hour on Thursday. Condemning incidents of mob lynching, Home Minister Rajnath Singh said the centre has advised the states to take stringent action against the culprits and has issued two advisories to the effect. The Home Minister also said the social media service providers have been asked to install checks to stop the spread of rumours and fake news that are fueling mob violence.
सरकारों की यह जिम्मेदारी बनती है कि राज्य सरकार इस प्रकार की जो भी घटनाएं होती हैं उस पर जो है प्रभावी वह कार्रवाई करें क्योंकि पुलिस हो अथवा जो है ये पब्लिक ऑर्डर हो यह स्टेट सब्जेक्ट है यह सेंटर का सब्जेक्ट नहीं है लेकिन यह स्टेट सब्जेक्ट होने के बावजूद केंद्र सरकार इस पर चुप्पी साध कर नहीं बैठ सकती लगातार जब इस प्रकार की घटनाएं हो रही थी तो तुरंत हमारी होम मिनिस्ट्री के द्वारा एक बार नहीं दो बार एक बार तो 2016 में भी एडवाइजरी जारी की गई और फिर 2018 में जुलाई के फर्स्ट वीक में भी हम लोगों ने एडवाइजरी जारी की है हम लोगों ने जो सोशल मीडिया सर्विस प्रोवाइडर्स हैं उनसे भी ये कहा है कि ऐसे फेक न्यूज र्यूमर्स रोकने के लिए अपने सिस्टम में वह चेक्स इंस्टॉल करें
The Home Minister was replying to a question raised by Congress MP KC Venugopal, who alleged that the government was not taking action to stop such incidents.
To express the serious concern throughout the country regarding the attack on freedom of speech and mob lynching incidents happening throughout the country. Madam, our constitution and rule of law grants equal right to every citizen to express his opinion. But the physical attack against the political opponent, physical attack against the persons who have different view, become the order of the day nowadays.
The issue led to noisy scenes in Lok Sabha with Congress MPs Mallikarjun Kharge and Jyotiraditya Sindhya asking the speaker to allow the Congress MP to complete his submission, saying that it was a serious matter. Expressing dissatisfaction with the minister's response, the Congress also staged a walkout from the house. Ravinder Singh Shauran and Navikram Singh's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
And now let's leave you with the image that has defined the monsoon session of Parliament session so far, while indicating the political possibilities and likely narratives in the run-up to the 2019 general elections. Thank you for watching the show.
Yes, Nirmala ji.